get you people!
You watch me bleed until I can't breathe. Shaking, falling onto my knees.
I really don't get you people.
As much as I hate Megan Trainor, Charlie Puth, and even Fifth Harmony, I can at least see why they appeal to people. Shawn Mendes, on the other hand, still manages to be one of my least favorite pop artists currently working, and his continued popularity irks at my every nerve. I hated Shawn Mendes so much last year, I put him on my worst songs list of 2015, and even then I feel like he got too much praise just for sucking. Also, back when I made my review of Me Too by Megan Trainor, Stitches was still on the top 50. That alone made me want to put it on my worst hit songs list for the year, but then Mendes released a single and it's now in the top 10. Fuck me!
I know what you did last summer. Just lie to me, there's no other.
Okay, so Mendes isn't always terrible. At least when he's put next to people with less presence than him and given a decently written and produced song, he doesn't completely suck. My ability to listen to this track aside, Mendes has no personality or even a good listening voice.
Something big, I feel it happening, out of my control.
This guy is the prince of irritating, only to lose the king's throne to Chris Brown. He's meant to be our new Justin Bieber, but it's worth noting that even in Bieber's beginning, he wasn't always this annoying or difficult to listen to. And so the Mendes experiment continues. What atrocity was he forced to sing over this time? Oh no! Well, this is already gonna suck. Alright, Mendes. What acoustic guitar intro were you forced to sing over this time? Really? He dropped the acoustic and picked up the electric? Well, shit, maybe this won't be so bad after all. I mean, I'm enjoying this more than Don't Let Me Down by the Chainsmokers. So, I don't know. What do you got, Mendes?
I won't lie to you.
Oh, God! Well, that was unconvincing. For a song about getting a girl to leave another guy for you, you're not doing a good job with a song. And now that I think about it, sulking about it in your apartment isn't gonna change that either. Jokes. But anyways, the song. Okay. Anything interesting happening here?
And you could tell me if I'm off, but I see it on your face when you say that he's the one that you want.
Well, now that's, actually kind of interesting. It's one thing to just say, hey, I'm better than your boyfriend, but this song is trying to be something else.
Do you feel like a man when you push her around?
So, this is Face Down by the Red Jumpsuit Apparatus, a well-applauded song for describing an abusive relationship. Unlike RJA, who's confronting the abuser about what he's done, Mendes is coming more from the direction of a concerned lover begging her to leave her current boyfriend. Don't get me wrong, the lyrics are basic, standard, lovey-dovey crap, but somehow I don't feel like it is. And I think I know why.
Better than he can.
This song is trying to be over the top, and believe it or not, I'm actually kind of okay with that. I mean, songs like Still Into You by Paramore try to be over the top, but they fail because they have specific lyrics, and they don't really match up with each other half the time. And where Mendes is by no means good at carrying this trope well, so far I'm not minding that. We're past the first verse and Mendes has yet to annoy me. I mean, where's the shrilling, squeaky voice I'm so used to?
I know I can treat you better than he can, and any guy like you deserves a...
Never mind. Okay, there's really no way I can do this review right without bringing up the main problem everyone has with it. Shawn Mendes. Even if people get past the lyrics to this song, which are all a mixture of desperation, cheese, void, substance, and douchery, the main problem everyone seems to have with this song is Shawn Mendes' singing. I've even heard people call it worse than Stitches, I assume because the choruses sound so alike.
You watch me bleed until I can't breathe.
Now that I'm thinking about it, never mind what I said about the Red Jumpsuit Apparatus, because if you can put aside the video and the third line of the first verse, the song is themed much more like this one.
Hey, hey, you, you, I don't like your girl.
being Girlfriend, one of her best-known songs and one of my best-hit songs from my childhood. As another song about getting someone to leave their lover and for the artist, it has a lot of the same problems as Treat You Better. Void in substance, obnoxious singing, no real good lyrics, and a bitchy artist. And yet, Mendes is giving me a similar sense of enjoyment that I get from Girlfriend. I'm aware of their problems, but for some reason, I can't help but like them. Now, normally, songs with even a similar message as Treat You Better would creep me the hell out. But in all honesty here, Mendes is too young, too immature, and at the moment, too flat of a singer to convey any form of presence. I guarantee you, put this groove in these lyrics with a more personified vocalist, I'd be sick to my stomach. Ironically enough, Mendes manages to make me stop taking the song so seriously, despite how hard he's trying to sell it. So yeah, I actually kind of enjoy this one. Not something I expected to say about a Shawn Mendes song, but look on the bright side, guys. I mean, it could be his other hit single in the top 10 right now. Stitches off my top 10 worst songs list. Perfect! The universe is finally in balance again. Well, I'm Kumerai Fang. Fuck you, Mendes! See y'all next time.